Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, first we hope that you are all safe as well as your families. Welcome to our first session. It's for grade 9. In this mathematics chapter, different types of numbers, we will start by the part 1. By the end of this video, you will be able to perform calculations on the fractions. Please, I need from you to prepare the following materials. So let us start by short revision for some types of numbers. First, natural numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Second, integers are minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Third, decimal numbers like 1, 3.2, minus 11.2, 0.023, minus 3, etc. Finally, prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, and so on. Now we will talk about opposite and reciprocal numbers. First, opposite numbers. The opposite of a number A is minus A. The sum of two opposite numbers is 0. As an example, the opposite of 5 is minus 5, since the sum of 5 and minus 5 is 0. Second, reciprocal numbers. The reciprocal or inverse of a non-zero number A is 1 over A. However, the product of two reciprocal numbers is 1. As an example, the reciprocal of 5 is 1 over 5. Since the product of 5 and 1 over 5 is 1. Now we will talk mainly about a fractions. Sine of a fraction equal fractions. And what follows given the number A, B, C, and D, where B and D are different from 0. First property. Minus A over B equal minus A over B equal A over minus B. Minus we can put in the left of a fraction, in the numerator, or in the denominator of a fraction. These are equivalent fractions. Example, minus 5 over 7 equal minus 5 over 7 equal 5 over minus 7. And minus 9 over minus 4 equal 9 over 4. Second property, a over b equal a times d over b times d. We can multiply both sides of a fraction by the same number. Example, 3 over 4 equal 3 times 7 over 4 times 7. Here, we multiplied both sides of a fraction by a 7. And we get 21 over 28. Third property. A over B equal A divided by D over B divided by D. Also, we can divide both sides of a fraction by the same number. Example, 16 over 20 equals 16 divided by 4 over 20 divided by 4. Here we divide both sides of a fraction by the same number, which is 4. And we get 4 over 5. Now, addition and subtraction of a fraction. First, addition of a fractions. A over B plus C over D equal AD plus BC over BD. Example, 5 over 7 plus 3 over 5 equal 5 times 5 plus 3 times 7 over 7 times 5 equal 25 plus 21 over 35, which is equal to 46 over 35. Also, x over y plus y over x, for which x and y are different from 0, equal x times x plus y times y over x times y, which is equal to x squared plus y squared over xy. Second, subtraction of fractions. A over B minus C over D equal AD minus BC over BD. This is an example. 4 over 5 minus 9 over 11 equal 4 times 11 minus 5 times 9 over 5 times 11, which is equal to 44 minus 45 over 55 equal minus 1 over 11. Also, 7 over X minus 3 over Y equal 7Y minus 3X over XY, for which X and Y are different from 0. This is an application. Calculate the following numbers, M, N, and P. Please pause the video and try to solve this application. Solution. We have M equal 3 over minus 5 minus 5 over 4. As we mentioned before, minus we can put in the numerator, in the denominator, or in the left of a fraction. So M equal minus 3 over 5 minus 5 over 4. And using the property of subtraction of a fraction, which is equal to minus 37 over 20. N equal 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 4. We take the common denominator between the numbers 2, 3, and 4, which is 12. So we multiplied both sides of a fraction 1 over 2 by 6, 1 over 3 by 4, also 1 over 4 by 3. So we get N equal 6 plus 4 plus 3 over 12, which is equal to 13 over 12. Finally, P equal A plus 1 over A minus B minus 1 over B, for which A and B are different from 0. The operation between the fraction is minus. So we use the property of subtraction of a fraction. We multiply a plus 1 by b and b minus 1 by a over a times b. So p equal b into a plus 1 minus a into b minus 1 over ab. We expand the numerator. B into A minus 1 is BA plus B. And minus A into B minus 1 is minus AB plus A over AB. And we get P equal BA plus B minus AB plus A over AB. And since BA minus AB is 0, therefore P equal A plus B over AB. Now we will continue about the fractions, but in multiplications and divisions of the fractions. First, multiplication of the fractions. A over B times C over D equal A times C over B times D. In multiplication of a fraction, we multiply the numerator by each other and denominator by each other. Example, 3 over 8 times 5 over 7 equal 3 times 5 over 8 times 7, which is equal to 15 over 56. Similarly, 3 times 4 over 5 equal to 3 times 4 over 1 times 5, and we get 12 over 15. Finally, 6 over 7 times 14 over 16. Please keep in your mind, in multiplication, we can perform the fractions. Here, 6 and 16 are both divisible by 2, so we get 3 and 8. Also, 14 and 7 are both divisible by 7, so we get 2 and 1. 2 times 3 is 6, and 1 times 8 is 8. So we get the fraction 6 over 8 equal to 3 over 4. Second, division of a fraction. A over B divided by C over D equal A over B times D over C equal A times D over B times C. In division of a fraction, we change divided into times and we multiplied by the reciprocal of the second fraction. Note, the reciprocal of C over D is D over C. Also, we can make fraction A over B over C over D, which is equal to A times D over B times C. For example, 4 over 5 divided by 3 over 7 equal 4 over 5 times the inverse of 3 over 7, which is 7 over 3. So 4 over 5 divided by 3 over 7 equal 4 over 5 times 7 over 3, which is equal to 4 times 7 over 5 times 3, equal to 28 over 15. Similarly, 6 divided by 5 over 8. We write 6 as 6 over 1. So 6 over 1 divided by 5 over 8 equals 6 times 8 over 5 equals 6 times 8 over 5, which is equal to 48 over 5. Finally, 3 over 2 over 7 equal 3 over 1 over 2 over 7 equal 3 times 7 over 2 times 7, which is equal to 21 over 2. Now, what is an irreducible fraction? And what follows given the numbers A and B were B different from 0? A fraction A over B is said to be irreducible if A and B are relatively prime. That means the greatest common factor between A and B, GCF between A and B is 1. Otherwise, it is reducible. Example, 13 over 7 is an irreducible fraction. Why? Since the GCF between 7 and 13 is 1, while 15 over 63 is not an irreducible fraction. We called it a reducible fraction. Since 15 and 63 are divisible by 3, so the irreducible fraction of 15 over 63 is 15 divided by 3 over 63 divided by 3, which is equal to 5 over 21. This is an application. Calculate the following numbers, E, F, and G. Write the answer in the form of irreducible fractions. Please pause the video and try to solve this application. Solution. E equal 15 over 20 times 2 over minus 3 times 2. The operation between the fraction is times, so we can perform the fractions. 15 and 3 are both divisible by 3, so we get 5 and 1. Also, 20 and 2 are both divisible by 2, so we get 10 and 1. Then we multiply 5 by 1, which is 5, 10 by minus 1, which is minus 1. So E equal 5 over minus 10 times 2. 5 and minus 10 are both divisible by 5, so we get E equal minus 1. Now, F equal 2 minus 1 over 5 divided by 7 over 15 plus 4 over 45. We work inside the parentheses, 2 minus 1 over 5 and 7 over 15 plus 4 over 45. We calculate them same as before, 9 over 5 times 45 over 25, divided 5 and 45 both by 5. Hence, F equal 81 over 25. Finally, G equal 4 minus 2 over 15 over 2 over 5. Here we work in the numerator of G. Same as previous calculation, we get G equal 58 over 15 over 2 over 5, equal 58 times 5 over 15 times 2. 58 times 5 is 290. And 15 times 2 is 30. So g equal to 190 over 30. Hence g equal to 29 over 3, which is in the form of irreducible fraction. Now, how to perform calculations on fractions using order of operations. First step, work out inside parentheses. Second step, work out the divisions and multiplications in order, going from left to right. Third step, work out the addition and subtractions also going from left to right. As an example, calculate a and b. Write the answer in the form of irreducible fraction. Solution. First, we work inside the parentheses. 1 over 2 divided by 3 over 4. And we get 2 over 3. Second, we work the multiplication. 3 over 2 times 5 over 48. So a equal 2 over 3 minus 2 over 3 plus 5 over 32. Since 2 over 3 minus 2 over 3 is 0, then a equal 5 over 32. Now, b equal 4 minus 2 over 1 minus 1 over 3 all over 8 over 5. First, we start work in the fraction 1 minus 1 over 3, which is equal to 2 over 3. So we get b equal 4 minus 2 over 2 over 3 over 8 over 5. Then 2 over 2 over 3 equal to 2 over 1 over 2 over 3, which is equal to 6 over 2. Then 4 minus 6 over 2 is 4 minus 3, which is 1. Finally, 1 over 8 over 3 equal to 5 over 8. This is an application. Show by calculation that I equal j. Also here, pause the video and try to solve this application. Solution. First, we calculate I. And using the order of operations, we start work in the multiplication. Then, in addition. After that, we get I equal to 16 over 20, which is equal to 3. Second, we calculated j same as before. And using the order of operations, we found j equal to 6 over 2, which is 3. Finally, don't forget to answer the required question, which is I equal to j. Please review pages 5, 6, and 7 from the textbook and solve the homework exercise 1 on extra sheet. What did we learn in this video? Opposite and reciprocal numbers, fractions, equivalent fractions, addition, subtraction, division, and multiplication of fractions. Finally, order of operations. Dear students, thank you for your attention and stay safe.